Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
You live one life, think thrice.
Yes! I wish everybody had the kind of energy that I have. Y'all don't even understand the magnitude of my energy. Ooh, child, it's a beautiful day. Have I told you that? My name is Tina Fierce One, and welcome to Scoop and Scoop. Ooh, child, it's official. All the slay queens are being taken. All the slay queens are becoming wives. All the slay queens are bearing kids and starting normal lives somewhat. Some of them have ended up there because, oh well, the money was available. Now, today I got an exclusive. Yo, it's juicy. It's juicy. Now, y'all remember when Ella got that whole car and they were saying it's Mbonye? I also did the story. I was like, wow. Mwebale kusonda sente ndiga. Wow. Don't think the story died out of that, because pretty much the media decided to keep quiet. No one is seeing Ella Nantumbwe anywhere. Last time we saw a sighting of her, she was at some function with like 27 bodyguards. What they were bodyguarding, we do not have a clue. But anyway, on to sipping some tea. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, let me introduce to you our latest mother-to-be, Ella Nantumbwe Bugalo people. Walala, 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 another slay queen is down. I repeat, mayday, mayday, another slay queen is down. Houston, we do not have a problem. We are okay. We are fine with this. Jesus is the Lord, finally. Oh, let me take a breath. Let me take a breath. Because damn. Oh, yo. Banange. Amauli agansanze. Negambu yabu ya. I'm like, who is this human being? Who is this individual? Abi, who makes this girl to settle down? Abi, this girl has given everything away to anyone and everything. Woo! So Stella Nantumbwe, the girl with the accent, former Miss Uganda, who is represented, is actually married. Okay, no, she's not married. But getting someone's child is close to. Now, from what I'm hearing, well, the guy, most people are confusing him to be Nigerian, but he's actually not Nigerian, he's actually Ugandan. Hey, Nina Manji. Ha! Nina Manji. But she's actually with child. I was like, oh, finally, Miss Ugandas know what to do. Have you noticed the trend with our Miss Ugandas? They get themselves either white man and get wifed immediately, or they'll have babies with rich men. Isn't that beautiful? It's a love story made in heaven and money. Oh, Jesus! Kazi, Ella has been, she's been MIA. She's really been missing in action. I was like, wait, why? Why is this heifer? This is one of the heifers we used to find walking around with all the slay cartoons and queens of Kampala. Zilch. Zero. Apparently, she's chilling in Arua, of all places, such as Alina Kampala, Arua, because the guy has investments in Arua. She's actually helping him build, I think, apartments or something. I'm like, good for you, girl child. Good for you. Wamana kula bangalai for you today. Yeah, the life of a slayer is hard. I'm so proud of this girl. Helen Lukoma came out and did the same thing. Now she done did it. Who do we have left? Fabiola. Emiaka jikuleka. Banabana bachitege dekati. Nawe, better ko chokola. I'm just saying. Wait, what was the story I was running? Oh, yeah. Congratulations are in order for Stella Nantumbwe, who's expecting a child. That was the story. But I got so psyched. Moving on. Now, you know how yesterday we did the chameleon story about, it wasn't actually a chameleon story. It was about Morgan Heritage and the, you know, Tomorrow's Leaders Festival. Yeah, we did the story. Chameleon took to Twitter. He was actually tweeting in time. And he goes like, it's a lie, blah, blah, blah. Then all of his wololos and pikeredes also took time to learn how to use Twitter because they were giving me one-line phrases. I couldn't begin doing a clapback with such idiots. But anyway, they all jumped on Twitter. They're like, it's a lie. It was, the concept wasn't a show, wasn't a flop. I'm like, Chameleon, you actually took the time out to call the different individuals that you know work with us in close proximity. Like I always tell you people on this show, but you have to understand, I can't begin shouting with you when I have my own facts. Now, according to Chameleon, he says the show wasn't a flop. There is a hashtag running now in Kenya, and they're saying, well, guess what? It was a flop. And the hashtag is, it's what? It's something to do with Morgan Heritage, you know? Hashtag arrest Morgan Heritage. Now, I specifically wanted to understand obuzibu bwa Chameleon. What was your issue with saying the show wasn't a flop? Because given the fact that I had, all of your artists were not paid. Actually, a couple of minutes onto you getting on stage, y'all wasn't paid until they gave you blank checks. No, they were not blank checks. Who would be that dumb? They gave you checks. And then hours later, you noticed that there was actually no money on that account. Now, when it comes to the people who are at the concert, Bubu, I want to tell you that we both know what it means to be working in media. We can make the media work for us. I sat down and looked at the video that you put up on Twitter giving us a clap back and telling us it's a lie. We performed well. Okay, Bubu. If you look at that video closely, now let me educate the people who just run on social and follow the masses without understanding how it means to work in a media industry. Camera angles emphasize a lot of things and take out so many things. When you look at the video that you sent Chameleon, it was 20 seconds. Now, gathered from the sources that were with you in your hotel room before you were chased out of the hotel rooms, yes, I said it, all the artists were chased out of their hotel rooms because they hadn't been paid for. Get that? You actually recorded that video 20 minutes of just being on scene. You were among the first people to actually perform at about 2:30, 3 a.m. in the night. Now, if you look at that video closely, you will understand that because there was lack of people or lack thereof people, they took the barricades, the first barricades down, extended the people to their front where the VIP was supposed to be. Now, if you are a good camera person and you know good PR, that is the angle I would take too. Sagala mtu woganya, because we have done these things. We know how to doctor certain things when we are trying to promote a chivulu. Question, someone actually came back to that same tweet where you were telling us it's a lie, we were lying, and they were like, Chameleon, I was on ground, I was in talks with all the promoters and the people that actually had this concert. Now, we both know it was a flop. And he gave you a classic example. When Palazzo's show flopped, would Palazzo yeke nina yategese chivulu ave yatagambe mbwe chivulu cha flopinze? Tasobola. When Fit for Makers show did the same thing, yandifudena abagamba cha flopinze? Tasobola. Now, I want to take a minute. Chameleon, I know you're getting into politics, and pretty much right now for you, it's a numbers game. You want to take a minute and have the same numbers that your counterparts have when they go to such events. I ain't got no beef with you. This story wasn't even actually about you. You just happen to be one of the people that we talk about, because guess what? You're representing the 256. That is Uganda, my home, my country. You're my artist. So if I'm going to talk about any artist, I'm going to talk about you. Not Morgan Heritage, not Yemi Alade. And what's all this bollocks of trying to lie? The hashtag that is going on, I have screenshots from different WhatsApp groups of promoters and organizers of that particular concert. And they're all saying the same thing. So, and this is now, in Kenya, one of the biggest names in entertainment is called Rafiga Heavyweight. He happens to be a friend of mine, and it was so good that we caught a minute with him. This is what Rafiga had to say about same side concert.
My name is Rafiga Heavyweight, CEO of Grandpa Records. Let's talk about Leaders of Tomorrow Festival, an event that we anticipated would be the biggest event of the year 2019. But I can say it was a big flop. And it's not that we celebrate flop, but sometimes we learn from it. I think with the organizers, I don't understand why they ended up for Kasarani, because Kasarani is not a friendly venue when it comes to such events. Kasarani is not known for any successful event apart from football matches. Lastly, I can say the lineup. The lineup would have ended with Morgan Heritage and Alain. Reggae fans in Kenya, you cannot mix, and we cannot mix for them anything else.
Like,
if it's a reggae concert, it's a reggae concert. Yes, you cannot start bringing in pop and all that.
I mean, I'm still gloating about this ish. Now, going back to Twitter, the feedback that was there, there's one comment that caught my attention. And this is what I wanted to tell Chameleon. Next time, before you jump for the statistics, the numbers, who is with you and who is rallying with you, understand, at times, there's a bigger picture. It's not all about you. This person tweeted, and they were like, when you arrived at the gate, the security guards would openly tell you that if you didn't have a ticket, they were willing to let you in if you gave them kakitu. Everyone knows, kint kidogo. I wonder how many people got in this way. Now, we just hosted someone on 527, who was the previous show before this, the Rasta guy that was on it. We asked him, you were on ground, how did it go? He was like, it was a flop. Now, Chameleon, at times, I do understand, if you want to shut me up, because your social media guys were there, right? Give me a non-stop 5-minute video clip of you on stage and the masses. Do that. Do that, and then we'll be like, my bad, I'm sorry, I'm ready to take the heat, don't shoot, hands up. But you came in guns blazing, and then you thought that it's going to be one of those things that can be downplayed. Guess what? It's actually a big deal. All of those artists, Yemi Alade took a minute on one of the WhatsApp groups. She was talking to a producer on that show, and she was like, everything was a mess. Hotel rooms were not paid for. This wasn't done for. I'm sorry. That's why most of these artists didn't actually come through. So I'm trying to understand, Chameleon. I get it. You're starting to think like a politician, but Boateng, sudden wars don't start. Don't start sudden wars, especially wars with things that have to do with video editing. Oh, I'm in the business, just like you're in the business. And as for you, Obulenzibwa Big IUG, yes. One of them is actually a social media blogger. What's his name? Bakaitabatia. Now let me tell you, if you had nothing to prove, you shouldn't have said nothing. On ground. I don't understand what is it with our local artists. What is the problem? Why can't you take a hit when it's there? Why can't you say it for what it is? Because it's so disheartening that you actually wanted to take a minute out for your glot and your glory and call out to us. We are just reporting the fact as was. You, a doctor in fact, as was or shall be or is, whichever way you want to doctor it to. Dude, I'm not the one. I keep telling all of you, I am not the one. When I come out and I say something, I have full proof of what I'm talking about. Now, we have called people down from here to Kenya the whole day. We have so many back and forth messages from onlookers, from promoters, from producers, from photographers, from social media people, and they're saying the same thing. There was no people. It's like, ogende namboli, no funakaba to. How many people does Nambole sit? Basically, if it could sit like about 6,000 people, right? 6,000 people, no funako 1,000, but you make the 1,000 count by pushing them forward to whatever stage there is. So, I think at times I get too sentimental with this job. Woo-hoo, child. I'm just saying, when I stand up and I say something, it's not out of hearsay. Now, Chameleon, you have a habit of not letting anybody speak their truth because you always have a truth. I will not be the one. I will report fact as fact, period. Now, if you have anything else and you feel like, oh no, you got us in the wrong context, or if you got me in the wrong context because you jumped onto a tweet without actually watching the show, please take a minute. Mama Daniela usually watches this show. But she was a fan. Take a minute, watch the show, then come out with your facts, with your proof. Is that simple? We can't begin doing this all back and forth. You're trying to run for mayor. I'm trying to support you here. Dude, don't do that. It's a bad look. It doesn't look good on you. Stop defending what you shouldn't be defending. Mind about yours. You know, focus on your focus. Do you get me? Your focus was supposed to be Nagenze Muchivulu. These guys came and ripped us off. You were supposed to stand with your fellow musicians, Yemi Alade, Diamond Platinums. Everybody was supposed to stand together and say, Morgan Heritage, what you did is wrong. Compensators, pay us, we're artists, we're performing artists, and we came to show the love. Because, I mean, it was something that you took water kongaba in Africa. But no, not Chameleon. Chameleon took a minute to have a moment for himself. The diva that you were, Boateng, the diva that you are. But it won't be me, honey boo pie pie. Not me. Now, if you have anything else, Chinonchi Gade, I will not reply to you on Twitter because Lately, your Twitter itchy fingered. I won't do that. I have people I can spare clapbacks for. There's some dimwits out there to be put in line. I won't stop with you. In other news, I wish you luck in your mayoral election, and I hope you do not get it twisted like Bebe Cool and Bobby Wine and start to do that nonsense of playing the masses in the name of getting numbers. These numbers disappoint. They will hype you on the streets and on Twitter and on Facebook and on voting day. Hey! Kitokota sichibike. I'm just saying. And that is my take for today, Olugambo Nyinalunji, but I just needed to let it out. Can I say I was petty today? No, I was being professional. Let's take a short break, and when we do come back, of course, we still have Yap and Trending. Don't forget, Scoop and Scoop is proudly sponsored by Lucky 3 Bet Chisoboka. For now, don't touch your dial.
Scoop and Scoop is sponsored by
Chisoboka. Kufuka bus, no jog. Chisoboka. You live one life, think thrice. Chisoboka.